गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक दैट इज इन्वर्टर चेन डिजाइन. ओके, सो टिल नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास स्पेशली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट इंटरकनेक्ट कैपेसिटेंसेस. Okay, interconnect parasitic. So interconnect parasitic. So here what we have studied, how to means calculate the resistance. So then capacitance. So that is for a means LO wire. Wire means this. Either it's a metal wire or a polysilicon. Okay, your metal wire, the resistance is small. Poly resistance is high. Okay. So that's why when you from these two this point we. You can use always metal wire for any routing. Okay, so best for routing. And poly, sometimes it is required, but though the high resistance is high for polysilicon, okay, so it's rarely used. Okay, rarely used. Whenever required, okay. So particularly in standard cell design, standard cell design. Okay, so poly is must. Poly routing is must because we have to only metal wire. So there is a chance of short circuit. So that's why we use poly routing in standard cells. But in custom cells, we always use metal routing, okay? Because we have options. We have option metal one, metal two, metal three. Other options are there. So instead of poly, we will always route through metal one because resistance is small, okay? And also the capacitance from poly, because poly is the lower layer, okay? Poly to substrate, that capacitance is completely higher. But in metal, though, suppose here poly, here your substrate. So this is your poly, this is your metal one, metal two. Okay. So if you use higher layer, then comparative capacitance. Okay. So this capacitance will be higher than this and this. So that's why this is poly, this is metal one, metal two. So always use both. This is high resistance, resistance high, capacitance also, substrate capacitance is high. So we will avoid this type of routing, poly routing. Okay. So this was we have discussed, and due to this R and C, there are several problems. So your one is so that delay increases, then your power consumption increases also. And then for your due to R, that noise source noise increases. For crosstalk, okay, crosstalk increases. So these are the disadvantages, and we have calculated R, C. Okay, so after that, what we have calculated that model, okay, that R, C model. So R, C model initially that is ideal model. So that is no parasitics. Okay, so everything is ideal. So no resistance, no capacitance. So whatever in the schematic, that is in the layout. Okay. And then lump C model. Okay. So lump capacitance model. So here only suppose there is a here that metal or poly whatever. So only we'll use that lump capacitance. Okay, finally you all the capacitors add will one capacitance. So no resistance because we assume that the resistance is small and frequency of operation is medium or low. So that's why no resistance. Okay, only capacitance. So then RC model. So in RC model, different types of models are there. Okay, long RC. Okay, then P network. Pi network, P2 network, Pi2 network, then Pi, P3, Pi3 like that. Okay, finally distributed. So in distributed, so this one lumped RC is the calculation is not accurate. Whatever delay value you get, that is not accurate, but it's more simplified and everywhere it is used. Though it's very simplified, so to estimate that delay. It's completely very simple. So that's why this and also it is overestimated. So what is the real value will come? So but in this model we'll get some more value. So that though we are getting more value, that is okay. Okay. So that's why we'll use this. But in distributed we'll get correct delay value. But problem is very difficult to calculate. Okay. So either spice simulation is required or Elmore delay model is required to calculate. Elmore delay model is required to calculate all this delay value. Okay, so these things we have discussed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, yes, sir. Have you gone through this? Or and if you have any doubt, then you can ask now. We'll start next. Once you are clear up to this, then we'll start. So I think no one has no doubt. Okay. So I think no one has no doubt. So thank you. So now today we'll start another very interesting topic. Actually, it is not in your syllabus, but it is very, very important for your project or interview or to learn the detail in this subject. So it's very, very important. Okay, this is it is nothing but the application. Whatever you have studied till now, that is the application of this. Okay, so this is nothing but a inverter chain design. Okay, so why inverter chain design? Because suppose you know how to design a inverter. So minimum size inverter you can design easily. Okay. So some gate capacitance will come. Okay, due to this some output intrinsic capacitance will come. Okay, some intra-wire capacitance will come, some fan out capacitance will come. So finally you will calculate based on that capacitances, your delay, your rise time, fault time, everything. Okay. But sometimes what happen? Suppose there is here one block, here another block. Okay. So we have to drive this block by this block. Okay. Suppose there is a wire. Okay. So you have to drive this block through this block. Okay. But the problem is, suppose here the input capacitance is very, very high. Okay. Very, very high. But this is output, this means this is very weak in means weak device, weak inverter. suppose two inverters are there. This is one inverter. So this inverter is very very strong. Okay, though very very strong, this means WL is very very high for this inverter. So the gate capacitance of that is very very high compared to this output capacitance. Okay, so in that case, what happen? Whatever the signal will pass, so that will what happen? Due to a very high capacitance, so here what will get?
Drop voltage.
Voltage drop. What other things will get?
More delay because of large load capacitance.
Okay, so definitely some resistance is there, or either intrinsic resistance from P or some path resistance. So RC delay will come. Okay, and who said delay? What said drop? So at steady state, you will get what at this point? Suppose you are giving a signal here. Okay, it's a heavy capacitance. So at steady state, what you will get? This is suppose 5 volt, 0 volt. At steady state, what you will get at this point? Are you getting what is steady state?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So at steady state, what will get?
Sir, as capacitance will be higher, so the charging time will be more. So.
Yeah, charging time will be. But at steady state, steady state means. Capacitor is fully charged.
Yes,
so at steady state, yes. What value will get?
Sir, at steady state, we will get 5 volts.
Yeah, 5 volt, you will get 5 volt. But due to this R and C, so there is a huge delay. Okay. So suppose this is your 5 volt line. So at steady state, suppose this is your steady state. Okay. So at, so up to this point. Okay, so it will charge. Okay. So at steady state, you will get 5 voltage because that time capacitor will fully charge. Whatever this voltage, that will fully charge. No current will flow. So that will be same as your whatever the input value. Okay, so at steady state, it will be 5 voltage. But during that process, so the capacitor will charge. Okay. So here, if this is a huge time, that means suppose we want to operate in a very high frequency. That means this frequency. Okay. So what will happen? So here it is one. So because it is start charging. Okay. When after this, when it will be zero, then it will start to discharge this. So it will never reach that high point, the VDD point. Yes or no? Suppose you are giving a signal like this. Okay, this is some frequency. If your charging and discharging is very, very high, okay, then you never get this type of shape because when input is 1, at that time, it will charge up to this value. So that is regarded as 0, it's not 1. So after that sometime, so when you will discharge, again it will discharge at that point. When again will charge, it will charge up to this point. So like that. So never you will get 1, always you will get 0 at the output. Okay, so this is the problem. So if a huge capacitance will be there, and a very small inverters or any circuit whose transistor size is very small, so it is unable to drive that capacitance. Okay, so it will take too much time to charge. So once it will charge, then you will get the response. If it will not get charged fully, then how will you get the response? So that's why this is the main problem. So when a high capacitance or a high load capacitance will be there, a simple or very minimum size inverter or minimum size block will not drive the capacitor. So that's why we have to think such a way that then we can drive this output. So easily we can get the output value what we require. Okay, so that is the most important thing here. So are you getting everyone or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just can you wait for 1 minute or 2 minutes? So I want to show something, one analogy that will be very good. Okay, so now I'll share one video. So everyone seeing this screen? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I think a few people have seen this. So now you can see.
We cannot hear the video.
So again, I'm showing you. So have you seen this video, or I'll play again? Hello.
Seen, sir.
Okay. So just I'll stop sharing. So what you understood from here?
The sizes are varied.
Okay, sizes are varied. So anyone else? So briefly, in two lines or three lines, you can explain what you learn from this video. I'll explain. I'll use this analogy in your this design, but what you learn, or if you relate this thing in your inverter design, then it will be better. So anyone? So Sneha, Prachi.
Yes, sir.
So can you explain?
Smaller size cuboid, the rectangle is driving the higher one, and the higher one is driving the more higher one, and that's why it is able to drive the highest one. And if we have drive the highest one with the lowest smallest one, then it would not be able to drive that. So for driving the higher load, we need to just put a smaller than higher, like that.
Yeah, exactly, absolutely right. So are you agree with this point, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the main aim to show this video is, so if you use that smaller cuboid, first one, to drive that last one, is it possible? Is it possible?
It's possible.
Not possible.
Yes, sir.
So, yeah, but the last one, you can drive that last one by using some ascending order, means lower then higher, then more higher. Finally, you can drive that final one. Okay. So if you use that smaller one, first one to drive the last one, it is difficult, never possible. Okay, so that's why here you can see. So that exactly we can explain here same thing. So if a smaller inverter is there, okay, and here a bigger inverter is there, okay. So why is a bigger inverter, or you can say, yes, so here a smaller inverter, here a bigger inverter, okay, and we want to drive this one, okay, you want to drive this one through this one, is it possible?
No, sir. Oh, sir.
Yes or no?
No.
So why? Because it's a huge capacitance. Because it's huge size, huge capacitance. Okay, CL is huge. So that's why this small inverter will not drive that capacitor. Okay. Ultimately, the signal will die down. So it will never drive this. Okay. So that's why the concept is that. So if you use a bigger inverter here, again another bigger inverter here, and another bigger inverter. So now it is possible. These can drive this, these can drive this, and 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 this can drive finally. So now you understood why buffer chain is there, or inverter chain is there, and how to design that. So qualitatively understood or not?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yeah. So now whatever the load capacitance will be there, this one will easily drive that load capacitance, and you will get the output exactly perfect. here also, whatever the load capacitance, this can drive this. This can drive this. Okay. So in this way, finally, the signal will easily and without an error, you will get here. Okay, whatever signal you will get. But if you use this one and this one only, so it is never possible. Okay. So that's why inverter chain concept is there. Okay. Inverter chain concept. So now in your project, when you are going to design a suppose word line driver, okay. Word line driver. So your word line, you know, in suppose in a row, how much word line transistors are there? For project students, if you are there, at least percentage of that you can say. So, you know that 256 column or 128 column into two transistors are there. Okay, that capacitance is huge. Okay, but after the if you want to drive that, so you have to use a very high inverter. Okay. But to drive this, a small inverter is not possible. So that you have to use some chain of inverter. Okay. So that's why it is important for you. Understood or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you understood these things, then today we'll start.
Sir, what was 256 that?
No, you will not understand now. Because it's the SRAM design, that memory design. Okay. That you don't know these things till now. That's why I said for the time that they are doing that. So now we'll come to this main topic. So till now I've given the introduction to know why and how. Okay. Why it is required and how we design. Okay. So now this is the sizing of the inverters for performance. Okay. And you know the inverter performance depends upon its output load. Okay, if load will be more, then your delay will be more. If load will be small, then delay will be small, high performance you will get. But here the CL is nothing but C internal, intrinsic or C external. Okay, C intrinsic is nothing but intrinsic capacitance, that is CGD. Okay, CGD, that is some Miller part will come, plus CDB, both N and P. This is the C intrinsic. And C external, that is your fan out capacitance, plus your wiring capacitance. So wiring or interconnect capacitance, yesterday we have discussed. Okay, wiring plus fan out. So these two things. Okay. So if these we'll optimize these two things, then we can optimize also our delay. Okay. So these things almost you cannot do. Okay. Only you can do by reducing the sizing. By reducing the sizing, you will get less gain. Okay. And fan out, we have no. We cannot do on this fan out. And wiring, we can do something by doing proper layout. So you can reduce this wiring. Okay, in this way you can reduce CL or performance increases speed. Okay, so this is the thing. So this thing here mentioned. So now we go slowly how to calculate the inverter chain or what is the number of sizes and what is the optimized delay value. all these things will calculate. So now you can see your TP is equal to propagation delay. I am saying about propagation delay. Already we have discussed the propagation delay for a properly sized. Properly sized means suppose your WP is equal to or WN is equal to, so that is mu N by mu T WP. So WP is equal to mu N by mu T WN. So this is properly sized. Yes or no? Because always use WP is somewhat higher than the WN. Okay, so that ratio is nothing but mu N by mu P. Okay, so here is for 40 something by 151, like 2.94 you calculated, 2.94 that value. Okay, so this is the thing. So properly designed inverter. Okay, so you know that R equivalent P is equal to R equivalent N. Okay, so for that, so if you calculate TP, that is, you know, TP is equal to TPHL plus TPLH by 2. So here, for a properly designed transistor, you know the TPHL is equal to TPLH, because TPHL is equal to 0.69 into RN CL plus 0.69 into RP CL by 2. So though RP and RN is equal to same, so now you can easily, you can write 0.69 R equivalent CL. Okay. So this is your PP. Okay. So now your PP is equal to 0.69 R equivalent CL. Instead of CL, you can write C intrinsic plus C external. Yes or no? This is the thing. So now your PP is equal to, for a properly transistor size, so R equivalent, that is either RP or RN, both are same. So R equivalent C internal or intrinsic plus C external. External is nothing but these two things, fanout and wire. Clear? So now here you can also, you can do, so 0.69, then R equivalent, that is okay, and here you can see intrinsic. If you take common C intrinsic, it will come 1 plus C external by C internal. Yes or no? So now you can again write this TP is equal to 0.69. Means this thing. So this is constant for a minimum size transistor. Okay, minimum size transistor, minimum size inverter. This R equivalent and C internal is constant. You cannot change. Okay. If your transistor size is constant and minimum, so this thing always is there. You cannot change. So that's why we can say it's a constant TP0. This part is constant, that is TP0, then 1 plus C external by C internal. Interesting. Okay. So though this is constant, so if C external. So if C external, it depends upon this fan out and this wiring capacitance. Again, if you see that is constant, that the number of fan out is constant, the wiring capacitance is constant, then by increasing this, what you will get? If you increase the size of the inverter, that minimum size of that inverter, it will increase. So this capacitor will increase. That means this value will decrease. Okay. That means we will get What will be the TP? If you increase this value.
Less.
Okay. So that will be less. Means if you increase C intrinsic, or indirectly you can say, if you increase the size of the inverter, then we are decreasing TP. Okay. So now I understood how the TP decreases with increase the size of the transistor. Okay. So definitely you cannot reduce this value less than TP. Okay. So if you hypothetically if you make it infinity. Okay. Very, very high size. Then this part will be zero. So finally you will get TP zero. Okay. So the minimum TP is equal to TP zero. And what is that TP zero? So that TP zero is equal to 0.69 into R equivalent and C into C. This is for a minimum size transistor. Okay. For a minimum size transistor, means inverter, so definitely you get this value. This is the minimum TP. You cannot reduce the TP value from this value. Okay, this is the minimum. So you can increase from here, but you cannot decrease. Okay, so this is one point. So now you can see this thing. So what I said. So this is your TP is equal to TP zero 1 plus C external by C internal. Where TP zero is this and call the intrinsic or unloaded delay. Intrinsic delay or unloaded delay. Because this is the minimum. Whatever you can do, but this is the minimum, this TP zero. Okay. Now I come to how transistor sizing impact the performance of gate. So now slowly doing this thing, then we'll understand how the transistor sizing impact the performance. Okay, if you increase the transistor size, how will it will impact or either advantage or disadvantage or delay will increase or power consumption, whatever the things. So now here, C internal. So you know C internal. C internal is purely depends upon that CGD plus CDV, and these two are depends upon W, size of the transistor. Okay. So now, if you increase the W, then this will increase. Okay. Suppose you will increase two times. This is also increased almost two times. Okay. So we can say it's S, the scaling factor. Okay. If you S time, this also increase S time. Okay. That means if you take CI reference. CI reference means this is the intrinsic capacitance for a reference inverter. Okay. Reference inverter means minimum size. Reference inverter, that is minimum size transistor. Okay. So for that we will say it's C intrinsic reference. Okay. So now we can see if you increase the size of the transistors. Okay. So what happens? C internal is equal to S into C I reference. If S time will increase the W of that reference, then the C internal will get that S time of that. Yes or no? C internal is equal to S reference, where S is equal to sizing factor or scaling factor. Okay. Now you know this is the way. So again, if you increase the size, suppose this is a PMOS, if you are increase the size, then definitely the whatever the capacitance that will sorry. So you can see, suppose initially it was C, now it will be SC, and initially it was R. So it will be R by S or not? If you increase the size, you are increasing sizing means you are increasing the strength. You are increasing strength means you are decreasing the resistance. In which factor? The S factor. So you are decreasing the resistance in S factor, you are increasing the capacitance in S factor. Okay. So now here you can see same thing. Resistance decreases, capacitance increases. Now if you can put that value, Pp is equal to 0.69, R referenced by S and C into S. Okay. And this is also C external by C S. Now you can see this S is cancelled. Okay. So that is fixed. That Tp0 is equal to fixed. But here you can see by increasing the S, so this value increases. Okay. So overall this value decreases. Okay. So now we will take these things, we will calculate for our inverter design, means our inverter chain design. Okay. So up to this thing you understood or not? So everyone, it's very simple, and if you are not following, I'll explain again. If you are following, then we'll go next step. Please.
Yes, it is clear.
So everyone, Samya, Vakar, Sushri, Akansha, Shradhan, yes. Sapnanjali, everyone following this thing?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah, from Bangkok.
Yeah, actually we have discussed last time. We will discuss only inverter chain related topic or else even in new topic we will discuss.
No, we are slowly starting from here. We will discuss the inverter chain after this. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Actually, we have discussed. You want to say
something? Yes. Thing I have discussed very in qualitative way, but here some mathematical way we have to discuss. Is the how to calculate the minimum delay and how to choose the optimum stages? How many stages actually required? Okay. So that thing we'll discuss.
Okay.
So here are two points, you can very important point. So anyone can ask in interview, because in your placement, suppose in any core company, they can ask this type of questions and this point. The intrinsic delay of the inverter TP0 is independent of the sizing of the gate and is purely determined by the technology and inverter layout. Okay. So that intrinsic, the TP0 is said, na? Okay, so that is intrinsic. If they will ask the unloaded capacity, unloaded delay, that is unloaded delay or intrinsic delay. Delay of an inverter. So simply you can say that is 0.69 R equivalent C intrinsic, and that this is for a minimum size transistors for a particular technology. Okay. So for example, I'm giving in very detail. Suppose you are using that is SCN, what is that? SNM, SOBM,
4M.
SN 4M, 4 metal and SOBM. So for the AL is equal to is 0.4 micron and W is equal to 0.6 micron. This is the minimum value. Okay, this is the minimum value. So for this, if you will design it inverter, this is P, this is, okay. So this is input, this is output. So here you will design, this is 0.4 and this is 0.6. Means W is equal to 0.6, L is equal to 0.4. This thing. And this is 0.6 into 2.94, because that is mu n by mu v is 2.94, and this is 0.4. So if you design this inverter, okay, so whatever intrinsic capacitance due to this size. Okay, whatever the intrinsic capacitance and what is the intrinsic resistance. If you use that and calculate that TP0 delay value, so that is your unloaded delay or intrinsic delay. Okay, clear? Yeah. So if you increase it two times, and if you increase in two times, then definitely means some you cannot get less than that because that is the minimum. Okay. Because you have some wiring capacitance or some fanout capacitance that I have not included here. If you include that, then your TP will be more. But this TP0 is the minimum unloaded capacitance, unloaded delay. So that you have to give the answer. And same thing from that previous equation, you can see that if making A is infinitely large, okay. So A is the maximum obtainable performance gain, eliminating the impact of any external load, reducing the delay to the intrinsic one. So that thing, that TP is equal to TP0 1 plus C external by S C internal. So he is saying if you increase this value, infinitely large, so if you increase this value, so what will happen? So this value will be negligible. Okay, there is no external. So whatever the value, that is the optimum value. Okay. So this is the things. So now you can see here. So this is the curve. Okay. So sometimes they can ask this curve also. So please just remember, you can draw this easily. Okay. Suppose if you scaling factor means sizes will increase. Okay, that will scale. Finally, it will be means minimum TP, whatever that minimum TP0. So that you will get. Suppose this is TP. So in TP0, it will be saturated. So whatever size will increase, that will be. Okay. So till now, we have discussed a lot about these things. So because it's very, very important for your sizing of this in your inverter design. So the sizing is important. Okay. So that's why we have discussed in very detail. What is TP0, intrinsic load, intrinsic delay or unloaded delay. And if you increase size, then after how much size, so almost it will be that TP0, there is no increase. So after that, no need to increase that size. So these things, practical things you need to understand. Because I said for equation wise, I said if you make it infinity, S is equal to infinity, then you will get TP0. But it's not same. So after some time, so definitely you will get TP0. So that's why you have to calculate after how many, yes, what is the value of S, no need to go over that. Okay, so that's the thing. And here, a simple example, so you can do this. So this is can say calculate the size of this means factor S factor. Okay, here. So this is your TP0 is given. Suppose 17.5 picosecond, and C internal, that intrinsic. 3.0 femtofarad and C external, suppose 3.1 femtofarad. So calculate the maximum gain. Okay, so maximum gain. Maximum gain means that part. So see, this is TP. TP 0 1 plus that C external by C and internal. So S term is there. So what is this part? So gain. So calculate the scaling factor where the gain will be less than 10%. Okay, calculate the scaling factor. You have to calculate the yes. Okay, when you will get the gain will be less than 10%. Okay, suppose you will get the TP value. I mean, see, this is TP 0. So this is your 17.5 picosecond. So 10% of this is equal to 1.75 picosecond. So when you will get 17.5 plus 1.75, 17.5 picosecond plus 1.75 picosecond, that is 5 sub 12, 19. So when you will 19.25 picosecond, what is the S value? Okay, so that this is the actually TP0, 17.5. When 10% means when it will be 19.25. So at this, at that point, what is S? Suppose this is S. So at that point, what is S? You have to calculate that. Okay. So you can calculate this in your home. Just I said how to calculate. So now sizing of a inverter, chain of inverters. So here you can see, so while sizing of an inverter reduces its delay, it also increases the input capacitances. Exactly. So what is the meaning of this point? The point is, when you are sizing, So always you want to reduce the delay. So what we'll do? So to reduce TP, we'll increase size. Okay. So but what happen? If you increase the size, so for a particular inverter, if you increase the size, then you will reduce TP, no doubt. So finally you can come to TP 0. Okay, but at that particular time, what happened? The input capacitance of this, if you increase the size of this and size of this, the input capacitance also increases. You know that CGS. Okay, CGS also depends upon the W. So if you increase the sizes, that input capacitance also increases. Okay, but here in this particular case, we are not considering that input capacitance, because this will load the previous stage inverter. Yes or no? So if you, the previous stage inverter, then if we are saying about the inverter chain. So anyone, suppose you will increase this value, so to reduce the delay of this inverter particularly, then the gate capacitance will increase. So it will affect this. Okay, this capacitor will affect this in this chain. So what happens? The delay increases here. Again, you want to increase this well, then this will increase. So finally, in this way, so it will interdependent. In a chain, if you increasing this value to reduce the TP, propagation delay, but it will simultaneously, it will affect the previous inverters. Okay, so that point is here. While sizing up an inverter reduces its delay, it also increases the input capacitance. So to determine the input loading effect, the relationship between input gate capacitance CG and the intrinsic output capacitance of the inverter has to be established. So that's why it is very, very important. We have to establish a relation between that CG and C internal. CG means that is gate capacitance of the particular inverter, and internal means intrinsic capacitance. Okay. So for this case, to determine the loading effect of input capacitance, input loading effect, so we have to create a relationship between this CG and internal for a particular inverter. Okay, this is suppose CG and this is inside this. If there is no load, so whatever the capacitance, that is C internal. So we have to create a relation between these two. Okay, so that relation we are here is equal to C in T is equal to So generally you said gamma Cg, okay, where C internal is equal to gamma of Cg. And the gamma is, so it may be, it will be vary from 0 to whatever the value, okay. But practically it's never, it will be 0, but in theoretical you can say, if we are using an equation, you can put any value. But it's, you can define C internal is equal to Cg, or you can say, anyway, you can say C internal by Cg is equal to your gamma. Okay, in this way you can define. Okay. Now, gamma is equal to, is a proportionality constant. Okay. Now you can put that gamma value. So Tp0, 1 plus C external. Okay, here in the place of C internal, okay, C internal, in the place of C internal, you can put gamma Cg. Okay, so why we are going here, so why we are going to calculate that Cg and C external, suppose. So this relation we are finally going to calculate. So why it is required? Because we know, we are saying that we will design a buffer chain, a inverter chain. So finally, we don't know how many stages will be there, what is the capacitance of this, capacitance of this, capacitance. We know only this value and this value. So if you know this value, input this value and this value, so we will make a relation. So that's why, if you know only intrinsic, C intrinsic, so you cannot do anything. Okay, so that we have to make a relation with Cg, with C internal, okay, C intrinsic. So that's why we can calculate, either it is, if it is one stage, then this to this. If it is two stages, then this to this. If it's n stage, then this to this. So finally, we have these two value. When I will give a problem or anyone will give a problem, so it will not say that how many stages are there, what is the internal capacitance are there, what is the internal delays are there. He will say, so you have to design an inverter that is input capacitance is this and that load capacitance is this. Okay. So this is suppose 1 femto, this is 100 femto. So your job is to design a inverter chain so that it will easily drive this 100. So after that you will decide, oh, this is minimum, so you want to use a minimum inverter here, but here a big inverter is there. So then how many stages are there, how I will optimize the delay. So that is important. So that's why we need this value, that input value and that output value. Okay, so that's why we are calculating this in terms of Cg, not in terms of C internal. So that's why we are using gamma Cg. Okay, so now we can say this part C external by Cg is equal to your fan out factor. And again I am saying, here I am assuming, assumption is one assumption, that is input slope. Okay, input slope is equal to zero. That means whatever the signal we are giving at the input, that is no rising, that is suddenly it is from zero to one, that is slope is zero. And second assumption is wiring capacitance also zero, for simplicity of calculation. So after that you will add these two. Okay, wiring capacitance is also zero. Okay, so only we are calculating that based on that input capacitance, intrinsic capacitance, then fan-out capacitances. Okay, so that's why this F is nothing but fan-out factor. Okay, that is C external by Cg. Okay, so C external is nothing but that CL, We are saying it is a CL. Okay, and this is your CG, that input. That means if you design a single inverter, suppose a chain of inverter, but in that chain of one inverter is there. So this is your CG, this is your C external. Okay. So now you will design only one. So this is the way. So if it's two, then according to that you will design the two. So this is a fan out factor for a particular inverter, for a particular single inverter. This is small f. Remember, small f, this is small f is equal to fan out factor of a single inverter. Okay, so later will come at capital F. That will be fan out factor of, that is overall fan out factor. Overall fan out factor. The difference is, so please, if you are feeling confusion, then please ask. I'll explain again, because it's a little bit. So here, gamma, first remember these things. Gamma is equal to your C internal by CG. Okay, so you know this thing. And small f is effective fan out factor. This is for a single inverter. In latter will come capital F, that is overall fan out factor. So here, so this case is a single inverter. Suppose this is your C external. Okay, and this is your CG. So this case, this is C external by CG is equal to your C external by CG is equal to small f. But suppose chain of buffers inverters are there. So in this case, this is C L suppose, or C external, this is CG. So that is capital F, C L by CG. Okay. So that is overall. So it's like a black box. Okay, for that overall. So remember these things. Okay, so that it will be easy for you to understand. So now, so you can see where a visual effect. So let consider the inverter chain circuit. The goal is to minimize the delay through the inverter chain, which is the input capacitor of the first inverter CG, typically minimally sized device, and load capacitance CL is fixed. Okay, so this is your things. So a chain of inverters are there. So you know only CG and you know CL. So no, you don't know anything about this. Okay, how many stages and what is the intrinsic capacitances? So your aim is to optimize the delay, means to minimize the delay with this CL and CG. Okay. So now, if lots of things are there, lot of inverters, lot of capacitors are there, so it is very difficult to also calculate, okay, for every case. Okay, well, means what is the fan out, what is the whatever. So, but here you can say, given the delay, so now you can say for any one inverter, okay, so any one inverter, suppose TPJ means for any one inverter, what is the TP? So we have to calculate that 1 plus CG J plus 1. Okay, so we know this is generally written as C external. Okay, so if suppose we are calculating TP of this, okay, so this is 3, that means this is suppose the capacitance C external. Okay, so that is nothing but this value CG, suppose it's J, then this value is nothing but input capacitance of this J plus 1. Yes or no? So that's why instead of C external, we can write CG J plus 1. Okay. Suppose we are calculating TP of any one. For example, calculating TP of this. So its number is J. Its number is J plus 1. So now, instead of C external, we can write CG J plus 1. Yes or no? Why you are silent? I think you are not understanding.
Yes, sir.
So please, actually, if you are not understanding, then I'll explain again. So, everyone understanding or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Because your feedback is important. Otherwise, I'll teach you, but if you'll not understand, it's no meaning. Okay, so remember, again, if you'll go through this video and if this note, then you'll understand, but maximum to understand here, okay? Then we'll go hand by hand. So see, here, if you'll calculate for any, so here main aim is you have to reduce the delay of all, okay? So maximum means minimize the delay. So that's why we have to calculate for one only. So here, TPG J plus 1 by CGS. Gamma CGS, already this thing you know. Okay. And here we know this part. OLS effective fan out. So effective fan out means output of this, output of input of this. Okay, now you can say so this CGS, CGJ, this is J actually. Okay, input capacitance of this and this is. So now you can put FJ means effective fan out factor of this only. So this is output, this is input. That's why this by this is called fan out. Okay, so clear? So now we can derive the total delay. Okay, total delay, how will, suppose we will know this value, this TP. So this has also one TP, this has also one TP, this is also one TP, yes or no? So for that, we have to, the overall TP. So here we have calculated TPJ only. For only one inverter, but overall TP is equal to TP of this, suppose TP of 1 plus TP of 2 plus TP of 3 plus TP of n. Yes or no? Because this is the overall length, means from here to here. So total TP is equal to TP of this. Okay. So now, the final TP what you will get, so this is J1 to N, okay, summation of, suppose J is equal to any one, J is equal to 1, 2, 3, like that. So J is equal to 1 to N, so your TP is equal to, TP 0, I think, okay, so this, yeah, TP 0 is outside, okay, so TP 0, TP is equal to TP 0, so 1 plus CG J plus 1 by gamma CG J. Okay. So here in the place of J, okay, if you'll put 1, then it will be 2, then 1, 3. Okay. So like that. So now we'll overall TP is equal to summation of this. Okay. This one. Very qualitatively you can understand. This plus this. Okay. So it's represented in this way, so no need to worry about this. So now here, if you solve this equation, it's actually very difficult. Means for every stage you don't know this value, this capacitance value. So it's n number of unknowns are there and n number of differential equations will be there, and then we'll differentiate that TP is equal to zero, then we'll get some solution. But overall you can say, means here in qualitatively we can say the delay will be minimum when suppose it's this is 2 2 3 Okay, so delay will be minimum. Means this is C suppose 3+1 C 4 by suppose this is C 4 and this is C 3 and this is C 2. So the delay will be minimum if we will make all the delays are same. Okay, so for that case C 4 by C 3 is equal to C 3 by C 2. Okay, C 4 by C 3 is equal to C 3 by C 2, again C 2 by C 1. If you make all this same, then you will get the overall delay will be minimum because we are doing delay of all the cells are same. So in this way, if you finally calculate, then the delay will be minimum. So that is if you solve that differential equation, everything will get this value. Means if C3 by C2 is equal to C4 by C3, then delay will be minimum. Okay, that is some differential equations are there. If you solve that, then you will get. So remember here, so that's why. So here what we will do, so C3 square is equal to C2 into C4. Now C3 is equal to C2 C4 root over. So you can say it's a geometric mean. Okay, now you can see CGJ is equal to CGJ minus 1 into CJ J plus 1. That means 2 and 4. Okay. So if the CG, we can make the CG of any particular transistor, particular gate is equal to root over of that CG of previous stage and next stage. Multiply with root over, then you can get a minimum delay and the delay of all inverters will be same. So this is the important thing. So for if you make these conditions, that means CG of any J is equal to CG of J plus 1 into CG of J minus 1 root over. Okay, so that we will get, the first point is we will get delay of all inverters same and overall delay will be minimum. So this is the optimum case. In any other case, you will definitely will get more delay of that chain. Okay, so in this is the only one case, so that you will get same of delay for every case and total delay will be minimum. Okay, so now you understood this point. Okay, for this you can refer the Rabe book. Okay, you can get this. So this means that each inverter is sized up by the same factor F. Okay, so this means, so what is he saying? Each inverter is sized up, okay, sized up by the same factor F with respect to the preceding gate, has the same effective fan out FIF and hence the same delay. Okay, that means if you will follow this rule, then so effective fan out, so these to this, again these to this, again these to this, so effective fan out will be same. Okay, so for fan out means that C external by C internal, that CG external by CG. So everywhere, for this inverter, for this inverter, for this inverter, for everywhere it will be same. Though it will be same, you will get same delay. Okay, and that will optimize your total delay. So now you can, with CG1 and CG2, we can derive the sizing factor. So now this is the first one. Here, this is, we have derived this. Suppose this is suppose one gate. Okay, so C G J. I said it's for one gate. I calculated this is for one gate. C G J minus one into C G J plus one. So don't confuse with J minus one, J plus one. It's one preceding one next. Okay, I can say C three is equal to C two into C four root over. Okay, like that. So now, if it is for one inverter, we have calculated. If it's n number of inverters, n number of, so that it's one. That's a root over. Okay, only one root over. Root over 2y. Now for n, so what we'll do? The we'll get C J one will given charging factor F is equal to C L. Okay, suppose number of stages are there. We know that C L and C G. So for that, your F will be C L divided by C G one. Is n root n, okay? Or C L by C G one to the power one by n. Are you getting this point? Up means this is one inverter, two inverter, this is three inverter, this is four inverter. Suppose four I am giving. So this is C L, and this is CG. Okay, so we know the so this value is some times of this. Suppose it's two, for example. If it is one femto, so this will be two femto. If it is two femto, this will be because its factor is two. Okay, the Fanout factor is so this is four. So this is 8, this is 16. Okay, so if you means calculate the overall fan out these to this. Okay, so it will be 16 root over of how much? This 4 four stages are there. Four. Oh, no, I said it's 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. No, no. Oh, it's 2 times 4, 8, 16. Okay. Then this is 4. So here, what is the case? So it's equal to suppose, yeah, it is correct. 2 into 2 is 4, root over 2 is 2. Suppose. So here, C L by C G, root over n. Then F is equal to C G one, C G given. We can determine the sizing factor. So anyone can say here this is 16 suppose CL is sub 16 and this is what will be that factor. Yeah, it's 4 actually. Okay, because for this stage if we'll say it's 2. Okay, so so are you understanding or with the CG1 and CL given we can derive the sizing factor. So F is equal to this. Yeah, sizing factor, that is 2 to the power 4, okay, usually 16. So sizing factor is 2. So clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if the sizing factor will be 2, so for that 4 stages, it will be 16 and it will be 1. Okay, so that is the thing. So CL by CG is equal to, your F is equal to sizing factor, okay, for every stage. So sizing factor is equal to CL by CG root over of N. Okay, so clear. Now you can, initially I said that capital F, okay, capital F is equal to overall Fanon factor, okay, that is CL by CG, okay, that is F. So now you are, I think, clear. Okay, so to find out the sizing factor, this is the for N stage. Okay, this is the equation. So now you can see. So this is your equation, and TP is your. So TP is your N, TP 0, 1 plus F to the root N by gamma. Okay, this equation, everyone understood or not? Please.
Yes, I understood.
Because it's N number of stages, so N TP 0. Now, instead of that C external by C internal, so that now we are using that overall fan out. Okay, overall from output to the first input. So that's why that is F we have mentioned, and that is root over of N because the sizing factor is this. Okay, at gamma unit. Now two things will be here very, very important. What are that two things? So here, you know, this is two part. So N TP0 one part, and if you multiply this, that is another part. So here, if N will be very, very high, what happened? So this part will be very, very high. Yes or no?
Yes,
then TP will be very, very high. Again, if N will be very, very less, okay, so come to this part. Okay, if N will be very, very less, then finally this part will be more or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because root over N will be very, very low means it will be very, very high. So now anyway, TP will be high. But it's like this. Suppose it's N, so in like this. So if N will be very, very high, then TP will be very, very high. If N will be very, very less, N will be very, very less, TP will be high. If N will be very, very high, TP will be high. So if these two contradiction things are, so definitely a solution will be there where TP will be less at some N. Yes or no? Yeah, we are getting this point. In extreme two cases, either it's less or high, the stages, number of stages, your TP will be high. But there is some point the TP will be less. Propagation delay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So for that, how will get? If you differentiate that and equal to 0, then you will get that value. Yes or no? If you differentiate this and equal to 0, then you will get the optimum N value.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now you will differentiate dp by dn is equal to 0. Okay. So now here, so this thing I said, n is equal to very, very high. So this is tp will be high. So now you will differentiate this. So who can differentiate these two? So dp by dm is equal to dp by dm mtp 0 1 plus f to n by gamma is equal to 0. Okay. So if you differentiate, so you will get this value. Okay. So how will differentiate this? So this first part is equal to ntp 0. Ntp 0, that is d by d ntp 0 plus d by dn. And this is ntp 0 into, so make it f by 1 by n up to the gamma. Okay, this part is simple. So you'll get that is tp 0 plus, so this is two things. So what you'll do? So d by dn of that is ntp 0 into derivative of this plus derivative of this into this. Yes or no? Two things, derivative, you know, I think. Are in. Okay, so finally, if this is there, means actually this part is okay, but this, what do you get? This f to the power 1 by n. While, so log, yeah, what do you get? Log f and 1 by n minus what is minus 1 by n square. Okay, minus 1 by n square, that is, yeah, that part, then into minus 1 by n square into n tp 0. Okay, n tp 0. So this part actually will get, this part will be okay. So because that will be simple, because you will get this is f to the power 1 by n by gamma into tp 0. Okay, so plus this part. So finally you will get 1 by f by n gamma tp 0 minus n tp 0 log f capital F, that is n square. So n will be cancelled. So you can take common tp 0. Okay. So this is the thing. So you can do this. Okay. So you are understanding this derivative or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you can do. If not, then. So finally, what you will get? So finally, what you will get? This is the equation you will get. Finally, what happened? So this is the thing. So if you will solve this, okay, if you solve this, so you will get this value. F is equal to that. Effective factor, fan out effective factor f is equal to e to the power 1 plus gamma by small f. So this is the equation you will get finally, small f. Now you can see, so this has only solution if gamma is equal to 0. So gamma is equal to what is the gamma value? Gamma is equal to c into y c g. Okay, if I assume it's never 0, so if you assume this is equal to 0, this is 0, then you will get means f is equal to e to the power 1, that is 2.71, like that. Okay, so this is the extreme case. So in this only one case we can get a solution, what is f. Okay, and from this derivative, all this calculation, we get n is equal to ln f. Okay, ln f. That means how many stages are required? N is equal to ln f means, so whatever the value f means, suppose I said it's 16. Suppose input is 1 femto, output is 16 femto. So f is equal to 16. So ln f is equal to, is 2 to the power 4 is equal to n is equal to your 4 stage. Okay. Got the point? If the input capacitance and output overall capacitance is there, then simply you can calculate AN is equal to LN F. Whatever the F value, put that value. F means that output load capacitance by input gate capacitance. So by this value, finally you will get number of stages. AN is equal to LN F. This is the most important thing. But how many stages with optimized TP? With optimized TP, the if AN will be LN F, then you will get a minimum number of stages with optimal delay. Okay, so next is, so now, and again, if you put the gamma is equal to zero, then you can calculate the individual inverter fan out factor, that is 2.71. That means suppose, what is the value? What is the meaning of this? F is equal to 2.718. That means if an inverter is designed, two inverter. So if is equal to 1, okay. So this one will be, the size will be 2.781. And again, this one size is equal to 2.718 into 2.718. That means the factor, S factor, 2.718. So for every case, this is suppose a capacitor. This capacitor value is 2.781. This capacitor is 2.7, like that. Okay. That means you have to increase the size of every inverter, next inverter, in this fashion. Multiplication of 2.71. Okay. So now, now this optimal buffer design stage, consecutive stage is an exponential fashion. Okay. It's called exponential horn. Horn, you know. That mic horn is in a, in suppose. Horn. Is that horn? Have you seen this? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir. Yeah, this, you can say chunga or mic, but horn. Okay, so this is, that's why this is the horn, exponential horn. So this is, so all are in the order of E. This is suppose 1, this will be E, this will be E square, this will be EQ, like that. Okay, the sizing. So that's equal, so horn, exponential horn. So choosing value of the fan out that are the higher than the optimum doesn't impact the delay that much and reduces. Yeah, exactly. Whatever we have calculated, solid 35. So you have class after this or?
Yes, sir, we have class.
Okay, we'll complete within 5 minutes. So what is the thing is, so we have taken gamma is equal to C internal by Cg. That we have taken it's zero. We assume zero, then we got the fan out factor is equal to E. Okay, but actually in reality the gamma is not zero. Okay, so if gamma will be not zero, gamma is not zero. Okay, so if someone, something is there, then this factor will be something 1.something. That means F will be more or not? Come on. If gamma is not zero, then F will be more. That means that instead of E, means 2.78, it will be more than 2.71. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that's here I'm trying to say. So what I am trying to say, so if this is actually means worst case, means to get the solution, we have calculated this F is equal to, actually it's not F, 2.71, it will be more. So that's why in your lab, what I said, so use, this is, now you can imagine, so in Prachita or Swatad, I said, use 4, Yes or no? So one inverter can drive same type of four inverters. That means its fan-out factor is equal to four. So that's why if you put gamma, that gamma is equal to one. Okay, so at least one, or it's not zero. So you will get some this F is equal to more. Okay, so that's why it's here generally used either three in industry. The more simple practice is, and they are using the fan out as a three or four. Okay, so here you can see if gamma is equal to zero, you will get that factor is 2.71. If gamma is increases, so now the fan out also increases. Okay, here you can see now that F is equal to this is the normalized delay. So F is equal to 4 or 5 you can use. Still your the normalized delay is not changing. It's at constant here. Okay. So but if you use that factor less, then your delay will be normalized delay will be more. So please understand this graph very clearly. When gamma is 0, it's 2.71. It's E, exponential horn. But gamma is there, so that's why it is increasing. So generally, the general practice is always fan out factor is equal to 4. Okay. So use in this way. That means for a very practical example, suppose I will say input CGS is equal to 1 farad, 1 femto, and CL is equal to 16 femto. So how many stages are there? Suppose this is first stage. So how many stages are there? If 4 is the fan out factor. So this one can drive at least 4 femto.
Four stages or three stages?
Now see, so one can drive four.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
And four can drive 16.
Can drive 16.
Okay, so in two stages you can do this. Okay, so one can drive can four, and this can drive 16. Okay. If 64, if it will be 64, then it's three stages. If it is into 4, 64 into 4, then it will be four stages like that. So in this fashion, no need to calculate. So by seeing this value, you can easily predict what will be the sizes and what is the number of stages. Okay. So please go through this and understand very easily. Okay. So up to this, no time. So this thing you can read. So or if you have problem, the last two pages. So you can discuss. So up to this. Okay. So thank you all. So understood everyone, or you have any problem? Okay, so you can go now. So those who are want to stay can stay, others go for classes. Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Prachi, Samisha, Sneha, Venkat. So till now, what we have discussed, understood, or still you have confusion?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually in Kang, some different derivation is used.